My dear friends, we are entering into the 22nd week in the ordinary times. The readings of today makes it very clear that God, who has created us, has a purpose. He has created you and me to have fellowship with Him, to know Him, to love Him, and to possess Him, meaning to possess all that of Him, because He is in need for the world. And through you and me, He wants to enter into the world. Through you and me, God wants His compassion, His mercy, His love to enter into this world. In today's second reading, we read from the book of Hebrews, chapter 12, verse 18 and 19, and 22 to 24. God comes with great glory and honor for the people of Israel from the mountain of Sinai. But the people, they saw the fire, the smoke, and above all, the mighty voice of God coming and trying to embrace them. But they run away from that. They say, please, God, don't talk with us. Maybe you talk through Moses. We want you. We want your help. We want your power to lead us. But we don't want to see you. We don't want to hear you. We don't want to relate with you. This is the tragedy of man's life even today. He goes to God to get something from God, but his heart never hungers for God. That's why Jesus responds to man. He says, you don't want to get my touch, but I will touch you. You don't want to hear my voice, but I will speak to you. Yes, He wants to touch us through His blood. He wants to speak to us through His blood. Yes, in the Old Testament, when Abel was killed, his blood began to cry to God. Lord, what harm did I do? Why did my brother kill me? Do something justice. Yes, today, when man doesn't want to hear the voice of God, he wants only the benefit from God. God says, I will come and touch you with my own blood. Not as the blood of Abel crying for justice, but my blood will do three things for you to cleanse you from all your sin. 1 John 1:7. And to fight for you, that every power of darkness that come on your way will be destroyed. Book of Revelation 12:11. And through my blood, I will intercede for you to the Father in every stages of your life, that my presence may accompany you, my presence may bless you. My dear friends, when God wants to touch us, man tries to move away from the touch of God. So God Himself dies on the cross, and through His blood, He touches each one of us. I remember some time ago during the retreat, a woman from Ongole, she was suffering with HIV/AIDS, and her whole body was full of wounds. She was feeling so miserable about herself, and her own husband who gave the sickness to her. And she was sent by some people. So she was not at all attending the retreat. The whole retreat she was cursing herself, cursing the man, cursing God. Why did you allow me to have this? And there came a session called inner healing. God spoke to her. Even before in the womb of your mother, I have known you. When you have gone through all these struggles, I am with you. Water is available for you, but you don't get inside and drink that water. My daughter, will you give your life to me? Will you call upon me? She could not resist. All the people were in silence, going through that experience, this woman began to cry, Jesus, I need you. Without you, I am dying. That's all. She just fell down. And with my own eyes, I saw in few hours, her all the wounds getting dried up. Yes. Man is getting stuck up with his struggle, with his pain, with his situation, with his sickness. And he can't see more than what he is going through. That's why God has come down from heaven and he has offered himself on the cross and tells us, you are more than yourself. You have someone who loves you, who died for you. And I have shed my blood to cleanse you from your sin, to fight for you from all the evil forces, and to intercede for you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let's then go to that mountain up Calvary, surrender ourselves to him, and being cleansed, empowered by the blood of Jesus. In today's first reading, we hear from the book of Sirach, chapter 3, verse 17 to 18 and 28 to 29, where the Lord says, if you allow the Lord to touch you, you will experience certain unique things in your life. Number one, you will be built in justice. When you are in the world may not accept you and give you justice. The people of the world may not trust you or even may not do what you are supposed to have. But when you give yourself into the hands of God, you will experience your God battling for you and giving you the justice. Number two, you will be remembered in the time of your tribulations. In everyone's life, there will be tribulations, struggles, pain. But one who has offered himself and moves with the touch of the Lord, he will realize amidst the storm, there is a boat that protects. Amidst the darkness, there is a silver line that guides. Yes, I have experienced him many, many times. Once, a great man with authority said, I will see to it his times come to an end. In the sense, he can't preach anymore. But the same mighty God, he protected me and he lifted me. The place where I was told not to preach, the same place I was invited by the highest authority to preach. Our God is a mighty God. Yes. When we allow his touch to be part of our life, when we give ourselves into his hands, number one, he will do justice for us. Number two, he will stand with us in our moments of tribulation we will experience. Third, he says, all our sins will be melted away like the ice. Yes, our God is a God of mercy. We are all human beings. We are all getting stuck up with the sin. But when we remember him and allow him to touch us constantly, when we give ourselves into his hands, we will experience him to do justice for us, standing in our moment of tribulation and forgiving our sins, making us his children. At the same time, the prophet says in today's first reading, if we don't allow our God to touch us, what will happen? We will not know our God. When we don't know God, we don't know ourselves. The moment we move away from light, the darkness catches us. And in the darkness, you fall, you break yourself, you lose everything. Second, he says, you will lose your responsibility. You will not bother about your own parents who gave life to you, because there won't be life in you. Third, he says, your mind will be moved into two directions. So nowhere you will get success. Nowhere you will have stability. Without God, your mind will be on the one hand stuck up with the world, other hand you will be crying to God. Next moment, after crying to God, you will get back into the world. You will have no stability. Your mind will be moved into two directions. Fourth, he says, without God, you will courageously throw yourself into the wickedness and you will die with your wickedness. God is calling you. Don't be like the people of Israel. He is calling you. He is the root of your life. If you are rooted, let any tribulation, any injustice come to you, you will live your life. That's why in today's gospel, the Lord gives a parable about a friend who is inviting his friends to the dinner. If you really love your friend, you always honor your friend. You are always conscious that you don't put your friend into any difficulty. So you go and sit in a lower place. When your friend comes, he will honor you. Suppose if your friend has invited someone greater than you, and if you go and sit on the right place, in the important place, it will be an embarrassment for him and for you. That's why he says, you don't choose your life. Allow God to choose you. You be in his hands. Your whole mind is how to please your God, how to be in the hands of your God, how to understand the plan of God, and God will do the rest for you. Yes, that's why in today's gospel, he says, there are people in the world, they say, give and take. I'll give you this, so you give me that. The whole life they make it into business, including prayer. That's why Jesus says, when you invite friends, don't call the people, those who call you back. And if they don't call you, your heart will be broken. But life happens when you begin to give. Because you have someone who has given everything of himself for you. Celebrate the one who has given everything of himself for you. You are not here as a beggar to receive something. Whatever you need in life is being given on the cross. Give and celebrate. That's why Jesus says in today's gospel, if you want to call anybody, call the poor, call the sick, call those who are nobody who can't give you back, and your mind will have a great joy. God has blessed me and I gave something of myself to others. And that joy we receive in receiving, now what we receive in giving is stronger than receiving. So learn to give, your joy will be full. If you learn to receive, maybe you may have to give back. God is calling us. Number one, be yourself in the hands of God. Let God relate with you and you relate with him. Move with God. Let all that of God move with you and make your life a celebration. Make your life that is pleasing to your God, and may God bless you mightily. Let's pray. God, Heavenly Father, we praise and thank you for this wonderful Sunday. You have spoken to us, the people of Israel, who have met you, who have seen the miracles of Red Sea, but they did not move with you. What a sad story. That should not happen to us, Lord. You are calling us not merely to know you, but to have a fellowship with you, to celebrate you. Lord, if you touch us, our life will experience you standing with us in the moment of injustice, in the moments of tribulation, in the moments of loneliness. You will be there to lead us. If we don't have you, our mind will lead us into different direction. Our mind will lead us into wickedness. Open our hearts, Lord, to make our life pleasing to you. We may be always in your hands, that all that of yours will be all that of us. Bless us, bless all those who listen to the word of God. Anoint them with your Holy Spirit. In Jesus' mighty name I pray. Amen. Praise the Lord. Quote of the week, Proverbs 8, verse 35 to 36. Whoever finds me, they will find life, says the Lord. And whoever misses me will hurt himself.